It's Omracer here. We are doing a review of a Morrison's Great British Ham, Chicken and Leek Pie. This was £2. I wanted to try something different. Now this is nice. I've had chicken pies before, like the pack of pies and things like that, and they're really good. So I'm hoping this one keeps up to that spec. We're going to unbox it, we're going to look at it, and then we're going to cook it. This is the box. Lovely design to show the patriotism. The pie is showing. The price is showing. Made by Morrison's is a good branding. Of course, our regulated ideas of high in fat, high in saturates, low on sugars, and medium on salt, which is very reasonable. Unless you're a Phoebe member. If you're on Phoebe, you enjoy the red bits. And the design is on the same on the box. Then we flip them up and all the details are listed for us. So the ingredients: double cream, wheat, whole grain mustard, diced British chicken and leek ham, creamy sauce encased in short crust pastry with a puff pastry lid. How we're going to cook it: 180 degrees Celsius on for 35 minutes. You leave the pie in the foil and we baste in the baking tray. How to oven from frozen, and then once we keep refrigerated, once we open it and so on, barcodes, things, customer service Morrison's, as they are lovely as hell, and all the details for how part of it, like fat, saturates, energy, everything like that. So much to explain, but let's open and have a look at this pastry itself. This has been defrosted for about half hour now, so it should be technically chilled, not frozen. So we should be okay, but this is what it looks like. With the puff pastry, beautiful, and it's a reasonably heavy weight. You can chuck it around and you can pie face someone, actually. It might hurt them a little bit, but that's how it goes. Let's get this cooking sorted then. That is our timer. We've got it on to just at 200. It's supposed to be about 180, so I'll go down by a little bit. They say place in a baking tray for 35 minutes. I reckon it might be 60, but we'll see how it goes. So I put it on for 40 at a little bit hotter just to see how it goes. And here we are. Let's see how it gets on. And now we've got to wait for the 39 minutes to see how it gets on from there. 12 minutes to go. We're just checking it out before we top it up or not. So we're going to do a little dig. Looking inside, that's looking good, looking all right, but I might stick that on a bit longer for another 10 more minutes, I reckon. And see how we go from there when we put it back in, because I cannot do this with one hand, no way. Almost burnt myself trying to get it out. 4 minutes to go, it's finally looking really nice and brown. And I can hear fizzing inside. That's a good sign. You can smell it now. You can smell it. There we are. Look at the gooiness in there. Oof, that looks lovely as fire. Mmm, look at the gooiness. I think, my friend, that is pretty much ready. So I will try and get this on the plate. I do not know how I'm going to do this because I've also got some baked beans to put on. We'll try and do this. I was going to use glass, but glass didn't kind of want to play with me today, so battery is needs to charge and I don't have time for waiting for that to charge. Fuck! Don't have time waiting for that to charge. And your last part. There we are. Now we are going to eat this. This looks really nice. As you can see, the meat is pretty tender. As you can see from the goo. Mmm. I know I've let it cool down a little bit. There's a very nice taste with that. The sauce is a very good sauce, even though it's a bit unhealthy. For the most part, it's a nice sauce. And toast the chicken with the ham, and the leek does give it a good flavour as well. And of course, trying it with beans is also pretty good. It just gives it a nice bit of flavour, and you can see the texture on the actual pastry bit itself is nice. So you can just hear the pastry just rough and crush as you dig your knife into it. These pies always have good flavour, and Mum loves them when we cook them. Because we used to have the pucker ones, which are actually next level. But actually, this tastes exactly the same, minus the fact there's ham and leek. But you don't actually taste much of the ham and leek, you taste the chicken and the sauce. And cooking it was actually quite simple. Just make sure you defrost it first, if it was frozen, or you put it on for an hour if you freeze it, which actually I did just under an hour. So it just gives up extra zang, and the crispiness and the burnt pastry really does cool, give it nice. It's actually, I do like slices like Ginkster chicken slice. Now I'm going to give this a 7 out of 10. It's a good flavor, the packaging is nice. It is sometimes hard to know if it's fully cooked or not, because if you don't leave it on for long enough, it might be lukewarm, depending on how you cook, isn't it? So, you know, if you're not sure on cooking, it might be a bit too experienced for you. If you're pretty alright, like me, you'd be fine if you're a master chef. This is easier than walking, really. And thanks ever so much for that, and I'll carry on with eating this lovely pie when I am watching a film in a minute after this. Anyways, Omracer out.